Hi, I'm Amy Bradley with Feel Better with Yoga. Now, you would think I'm not often at a desk, but I actually am. Lots of computer work, lots of paperwork, and I thought, to be fair, I'd dress in work clothes so that you can see these are things that you can do at your desk without being in yoga clothes. So the first thing we're going to do is inhale, big deep breath, bringing your arms up above your head, clasp your hands together. Exhale, bend towards one side, making a little bit of a crescent shape with your upper body. Take a breath and let it out. One more time, breathe in, breathe out. Come back to center, arms above your head, breathe in. Exhale to the side, the other side. Big stretch through the rib cage, through the armpit. Crunching up this side of your waist, you're keeping your tummy tight. Take a couple of breaths here. One more breath. Exhale, come back to sitting up tall. Exhale, let your hands come down into your lap. Now you might want to sit forward on the edge of your chair. Reach back behind you. We're going to clasp the hands together. Or if that doesn't feel good, grab the edges of your chair. Whatever works, whatever you can. And then once you're settled with your hands on the chair or hands behind you, pull the shoulders back, opening the chest. Your head can stay looking straight ahead, or if it feels good, if it's okay on your neck, you can let your head drop back. Either way, taking several slow, deep breaths here, really feeling your chest open, giving your upper back a chance to stop being stretched so hard like it is all day when we sit at the computer, at a desk, or at the steering wheel all day. Take one more breath here. Exhale, gently relax your upper body, then let go of your hands. Come sitting back, normal, in your chair. Hands on your lap, we're gonna come into seated cat and cow. So as you inhale, arch the back, coming into cow with that sway back that they have, shoulders back, kind of like what we were doing a second ago. Exhale and round, curl up your upper body, stretching and opening the shoulder blades. Keep that going. Inhale, arching. Exhale, rounding. We look for so many opportunities to undo the posture that we have all day long sitting at our desk or driving the car. We're always hunched over. So we look for ways to open that up and let everything relax. One more. After that exhale, come back to neutral spine. Let's twist towards one side. Your seat and legs are going to stay facing in the chair the way they normally would when you're sitting. We're going to turn toward the side, elbow or arm behind or on your chair, depending on what chair you've got. Other hand to the side of your thigh. Breathe, gentle twist around. And here, we're not trying to pop our back, just a gentle twist, keeping the tummy tight. Really, we're only pulling with this arm to help pull us around. And breathing while you do this. Letting your body relax into this twist. As you exhale, come back to facing straight ahead. Go to the other side. You can look at my back for a minute. Okay, so other arm comes behind the chair. Gentle twist to the side. Breathe. Two more breaths here. One more breath. Exhale gently. Come back to facing straight ahead and neutral. We're going to come to standing up. Oops. Whoa. You may not be able to see all of them. Okay. We're going to put our hands facing the desk, feet facing straight ahead, about hip distance apart, hands on the desk. Let's walk the feet back just to as far back as you want to go. We're coming into a modified downward facing dog, but at the desk. So you can bring your hands here to the desk or your elbows, and you're going to feel this great opening and stretch through the lower back, and also a big stretch of the hamstrings. Both my heels are on the floor. If you're wearing shoes or heels, take them off. This is your time. And then I like to kind of march my knees in place, giving each leg a chance to stretch all by itself. And if this feels fantastic, but you'd like it to feel even better, walk your arms forward on your desk, reaching as far as you can, letting your back be neutral. If your back is starting to round like this, then come up away from the desk a little bit, or put more bend in your knees. So downward facing dog is not a position we want to wind up in. It's the starting point. It's the place that we start, and then we explore, and then we march, and we move, and we find where the stretch feels good, finding the tightness. All right, both knees fairly straight, hands on the desk. Bring yourself back up. We're coming into plank, which is like a push-up position, but we're not pushing up yet. We're going to hold onto the desk, thumbs curled under to give you some support, straight arms, and both my heels are pulling down into the floor. So my feet are flat on the floor, and I've got this long, straight body, one long line of energy, so no bend right here. And then we will come into a few mild push-ups, going to where you want them to be. So we'll take a breath in. Exhale, come forward, bending the elbows, keeping the elbows close in towards your body. Exhale, push away from the desk. And again, inhale. And this can be little. You don't have to go all the way down. Exhale. Keep that going. Inhale. Exhale back. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Exhale, push away from your desk. Relax, walk your feet back in. So now I'm going to stand beside my desk, holding onto the back of my chair, coming into what's called dancer. I'm going to bring one hand out to the side, bend that knee, the same leg, and hold onto that ankle. If you can get your hand on the inside of the ankle, that's even a little bit better because it helps open the shoulder and pull the shoulder back, opening the chest. If you can't get your hand like that, don't worry about it. It doesn't matter. Just grab your ankle. We're going to breathe. Let this leg sort of dangle, trying to get it to straight down. And it depends on you. It might not go to straight down. It might hang easily. If you're not feeling any stretch in the quadricep or the hip flexor, pull the knee back just a little bit. And then you'll feel it. It's like a real zinger right in there. Very tight hips from sitting at a desk all day. Breathe there. Exhale. Gently let that foot down. Let the leg straighten out. Then we switch. Other side. Hand out. Excuse me. Hand comes to hold onto the ankle. And then we'll pull that side back. You should be feeling it mostly right here, up this quadricep and deep in the hip flexor. The knee is hanging down by the other knee. It's not out to the side because that'll decrease the stretch where it needs to be. Always breathing. If I'm not saying it, you still breathe. Listen to your breath. One more breath. Exhale, gently let that leg down. Pull your chair back out, come back to sitting. I'm going to come into a seated figure four. This is a big one for the hips to stretch. We're going to cross one leg over, ankle on top of the thigh, not the foot because then the ankle isn't supported. Ankle on top of thigh, we'll sit up tall, take a breath in, exhale, come forward. Fairly straight upper body. Relaxing towards your lap, and you'll feel in the hip of that crossed leg. Now, if this is too much, just cross your leg right here and come forward. In fact, that's quite a bit of stretch right there. Take several breaths here. Let your head hang. And as you exhale, use your hands in your lap to push back up to sitting up tall. Uncross that leg and switch other leg. Cross it over, ankle on top of the thigh. Sit up tall, big breath in. And exhale, fold forward. We're trying to keep the spine neutral so we're not rounding too much because that can strain the back. And remember, here or here. It's the same pose, same stretch, just different degrees of it depending on where you can go. Every exhale, let that hip muscle relax. Let it soften a little bit. One last breath here. And as you exhale, push back up away from your lap, uncross that leg, and then we'll sit facing this way or facing the desk. Hands relax, let them fall in your lap. You're sitting up nice and tall, or if you need to, you can lean back, do what's comfortable. And give this last minute to yourself. Close your eyes. Let go of all the holding on to the worries and thoughts of things that you've got to do next, the things that you needed to do before you started practicing. Let this be your time. Feel the breath come into your body. Feel it as it leaves. Every breath expanding and energizing you. But every exhale, letting yourself release tension and sink a little heavier into your chair. You feel your shoulder blades against the back of the chair, and you feel your bottom and thighs pressing into the seat. You can feel your feet gripping the floor, fully grounded. Stay here as long as you can, or as long as you have. And when you're ready to come back to your workday, take one last breath in for yourself. Exhale, let it out. Bring your hands together at your heart. Give yourself a little acknowledgement for taking care of yourself today and slowing yourself down in the middle of a crazy work day, stretching your body like it needed to stretch. The light that is in me honors and shines on the light that is in you. Namaste. Now you can get back to work. See you next time.